Who wants those boring static infographics when you can make something like this? Smooth, dynamic, and honestly way more fun. In just a few minutes, let's build one together. Come straight into the Fusion page, add a background node, you will get a media out with it. So Resolve already drops a Fusion composition for you back in the edit page. Alright, let's start building. Add an ellipse and a background and connect the ellipse into the background so we get a clean circle shape. Now drop in a merge after that first background and hook your second background into the green input. To keep things clean for later, especially if you are turning it into a macro, rename your ellipse as base ellipse, then its background, and call it base background. Set this one to white. Now select base ellipse and uncheck solid, increase the border width just a bit, and set width and height to around 0.2 so we get a nice ring. Drop the level to around 25%. Now we need the exact same circle but in a bright color. No need to rebuild anything. Just copy and paste those two nodes, select them both and batch rename them. Circle ellipse and circle background. Connect this background into the previous merge and give it a bright color. And don't forget to reset its level back to 1. Now we have got both circles stacked on each other. Let's animate. But first, select the bright circle and set its length to 0. Then select the base ellipse and drop its length to around 0.02 so it starts a tiny bit earlier. Now place them right where you want your animation to begin. I think it looks good right about here. Position the bright circle right with it. Perfect. Select base ellipse. Make sure you are on frame 0. Add a keyframe on length. Jump to around frame 45 and set length to 1 so it completes the full spin. Now the bright circle. Back to frame 0, add a keyframe on length, then hop to around frame 65 and take the length up to something like 0.82, about 82%. Let's preview that. Cool, but it needs a little polish. Select the base ellipse, open the spline editor and make sure show only selected tool is checked. Zoom to fit, select both keyframes and hit S to smooth them. Tweak the handles if you want that extra polish. Now smooth the motion for the bright circle too, so the whole animation feels clean and pro. Let's see the difference. Yeah, that's looking nice. Almost done. Let's add the numbers and the percentage sign. Drop in a text plus node, rename it value text, and connect it into the previous merge. Pick a clean readable font, go to frame 0, type 1, and keyframe it. Now move forward a few frames at a time and update the number roughly based on how far the bright circle has moved. It doesn't need to be perfect, except the final value. That should match the final fill. Let's check. Looks good. Now add another text plus node. Connect it into the main flow and type the percentage sign. Make it a little thinner so it pairs well with the number. Adjust both text nodes until they are centered nicely inside the circle. Now, for a little cherry on top, select value text, go to frame 0 and under shading drop the opacity to around 0.4 and keyframe it. Jump to frame 65 and bring opacity back to 1 for a gentle breathing effect. We want the same for the percentage sign. But instead of keyframing again, just right-click its opacity, connect to, value text, opacity 1. Boom, same animation, synced perfectly. Finally, let's give the whole infographic a stylish entry. Select your last merge and add a transform node after it. Before we animate this, select background 1 and bring its alpha all the way down to 0 so we can get a transparent background. Select the transform, go to frame 0, and keyframe the center. Move about 20 frames ahead and nudge the whole infographic slightly to the right. Open the spline editor. This time, just smooth the second keyframe for a snappy start. Let's check. Yeah, that comes in really smooth. If this helped, hit like and subscribe.